Dear student, I am going to talk about in this video very important topic, metallic bonding. So we all know that in chemistry there are three kinds of bonding: ionic bonding, covalent bonding and metallic bonding. What is ionic bonding? It is the bonding which form between the metals which form cation and the non-metal which form anion. So this is basically the bonding between the metal and the non-metals. What is covalent bonding? It is the bonding which form between the two non-metal via sharing of electron. For example, here as you can see here H2O, where the electrons share to become a stable like a neutral gas, noble gas, right? And what is metallic bonding? This metallic bonding is a bonding which present only in the metals, which is basically the bonding between the metal cation and the electron. So we are going to talk about in this video about metallic bonding in a bit detail. So let's talk about what do you mean by metallic bonding. So basically, as you know that in the metals, the electrons are loosely packed. So that's why they always form the cation and the electrons are just beside there and they are just attracted to these electrons over there. So this is the bonding between the metal cations which is formed by just losing the valence electron to the neighboring valence electron. So this is the bonding which held atom together in the metals. Very important. So how this is different from the covalent and ionic bonding? It is because the electrons are delocalized, means the electrons are not in their place. The valence electron are still moving in the metals and they are not even shared between the two different atoms. They are just only one metal cation. There are no different metal cations. And electron, whatever is there, they are still there. It's not like this metal is completely lost the electron out of the metals. So this is not shared. That's why covalent bonding. Since there is no metal and non-metal, that's why it is not ionic bonding. It's completely different. It's metallic bonding. So metallic bonding, electrons float freely through the lattice of the metal nuclei. And whatever property we see like thermal conductivity, electrical conductivity, they have high melting and boiling point, malleability. These all properties only because they have unique metallic bonding, which is only present in the metals. So let's talk about this in a detail. So this is all property what I was talking to just now, that they have lustrous appearance. It means the shining appearance typically for the metals. And they are good conductor of heat and electricity because they have delocalized electron which can move thoroughly in the metals. They are ductile. Ductile means you can draw into the wires. So how to remember ductile word? Ductile, drawn into the wires. Malleable means you can hammer it without breaking and you can make in different seats, you can make a pot. They are strong, they are electrical conductivity. Anyway, I am going to talk about this in a bit detail in the last point, so be with me. Now metallic bonding is a bonding which is formed between the valence electron of the metal atom that are shared by more than one neighboring atom. Now what does it mean? Okay, let's understand in a bit detail. If you look all the metals, student, in all the metals, the last cell of the metal is basically, if you see, they have either one electron, two electron or three electron. For example, let's take example of sodium. So sodium you have 11, so basically you have 2, 8, 1. If you talk about magnesium, it's a 2, 8, 2. Aluminium, it's a 2, 8, 3. So to become like noble gas, they can easily lose one electron, they can lose two electron, they can lose three electron. Why? Because rather than accepting seven electron here, rather than accepting six electron here and here five electron, they better prefer to lose electron. So these electron can loosely attracted to the nucleus and it can easily be given that. So that's why these metal lose the valence electron very quickly in their metals. And they are shared by more than one neighboring atom. Now what does it mean? Let's take example here is silver. Okay, so silver is a metal which will form the cations by losing the valence electron. However, electron is not going anywhere. The same electron can be attracted to this metal, this metal ion, all the metal ions. So metal atoms are held together by sea of electron floating around it, and this is called metallic bonding. So if someone will ask you what is metallic bonding, you should say metallic bonding is a bonding which held metal atom together by attraction between the sea of electron and the metal cation. Okay, so metal consists of the lattice of positive ions through which the cloud of electron moves. So here you can see here they are in lattice, and positive ions are held attracted to the electrons, and that's why they are in fixed positions. So positive ions will tend to repel one another but held together by negatively charged electron cloud. So that's why it is overall balanced. Now mobile electron can transfer the thermal vibration, which I'm going to talk in bit detail. This is a very important example, the physical property of the metals. Sorry, some parts is cut here. So first we are going to talk about all the metal have high density. Very important. You know, density formula is equal to mass upon volume. And here what happened? The metal atoms are very closely and regularly packed. So if you take example of the metal atom, these are tightly packed. So obviously, if you take about same amount of the unit volume to the metal and other component, the same volume, for example, if I'm talking about 1 cm³ here, 1 cm³ here in a metal and some X material, this will have fit more number of particles. So it will have definitely more mass with the same volume. So that's why they have always high density. So why it is like that? Because all atoms are held together by strong electrostatic force of attraction between what? Between positive ions and sea of delocalized electrons. And that's why they are tightly fit in a small unit of the area. Now they have high melting and boiling point. Why? Whenever this word comes, strong electrostatic force of attraction, always remember that this force of attraction is very, very high. And to break this, we really need to put lots of energy. Okay, that's why the melting and boiling point is very, very high. So metallic bonding is a kind of electrostatic force of attraction. That's why you need lots of energy. They are a good conductor of electricity because the delocalized mobile electrons move towards the positive terminal wherever the potential difference will vary across the metals. They are good conductor of heat because it can transfer the vibration through metal atom which are closely packed and regularly arranged, and the mobile electron also transfer heat easily. So it can happen with the two method. First, since the atoms are closely packed, so they can vibrate and transfer here. Second, the mobile electron can also transfer. So the two method by which it is good conductor of heat. Why they are good malleability and ductile? Because they are the layers of the metal cations which can slide over other layer through the sea of delocalized electrons. So we are going to talk in bit detail here. So because this is very important from exam point of view, so you can pause the video and make some short notes on this small points. So malleability and ductile, sometimes the student always get confused how to remember. See here, I will tell you some clue here. Malleability, okay, malleability, their L is coming, right? So you can remember that it can be hammered in shape, right? So you can hammer it. Ductile means it can drawn into the wires. Okay, the two method which is makes the metal completely different. So why this is possible? Because it is the ability of atom to roll over each other into new position without breaking the metallic bonding. So let's see the example. If you put a small stress here into this metal, they are all arranged in the layers. So what will happen? This layer will roll over each other, and when the stress is released again, it will again come back to the original place. So somehow you can say metal is elastic. If you put larger stress onto it, the atoms roll over each other into a new position, and metal will permanently can be changed. So these are the make the metal completely different. So I hope you like this video. Let me know any doubt you have regarding the metals. So thanks for watching. Thank you.